Amen. Hello, viewers. Thank you for tuning in to Seeing the Impossible Faith Center. My name is Pastor Greg Marilla. I am always honored. I feel privileged when the Lord allows me to get behind his pulpit and bring what he has told me to bring. Praise the Lord. Well, before we do any type of teaching or sharing the word, you know what we do? We go to the throne. So I like every head to be bowed. Bow your head and close your eyes. Praise the Lord. In the name of Jesus. And let's go to the throne. Gracious Father, we come before you in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, we love you. We honor you. We praise you. And we give you glory. We give you praise. Father God, I thank you because you told us not to be anxious for nothing. You told us in everything, to pray and to give you thanksgiving. Well, Father, we're here tonight to give you thanksgiving. And you also told us to let our request be made known to you. You, the God of peace, who surpasses all understanding. You will guard our hearts. And you will guard my mind. Through Jesus Christ, thank you, Father. Thank you for hearing our prayer tonight. In Jesus' name, I pray, and all God's people say, Amen. Praise the Lord. Like we normally do out of the book of Psalm, we give God a form of praise. We give a clap. Clap unto the Lord. Amen. And then we surrender to the Holy Spirit. It's just a form of respect. Praise the Lord. All right. Remember the title of the teaching has been God's Will for Our Life. Praise the Lord. The last time we were together, I said to you guys, that God's word is a spiritual motivation. And how many of us agree with that? God's word is spiritual motivation. I don't know about you, but when I'm feeling down and out or tired and I put on the word of God or I read the word, it rejuvenates me. It just picks me up. Praise the Lord. So God's word is a spiritual motivation. And it motivates what? Our spirit. Spiritual motivation. Praise the Lord. Amen. It builds, it guides, it leads. Oh, God. I believe that when you hear the word of God, it builds you spiritually. We just said that, but I'm going to say it again. It builds you physically. Praise the Lord. Yes, it does. It teaches you things about your body. It builds you up mentally. Praise the Lord. Yes, it does. And also financially. If you're really a student of the Bible will tell you how to handle your money. Okay? And I'll tell you, not to love the money, but to respect it. Praise the Lord. It's just a tool. That's all it is. Socially, the Bible will build you up. The Word of God will build you up. So we can say that the Word of God can change our lives. Praise the Lord. Every time I hear the Word of God, it just changes my life. And we also went to the book of Hosea, let's go there. Hosea chapter 4, please. Hosea. In the Bible, in the Old Testament. The prophet Hosea. Hosea 4:6 said that his people, my people, are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. That's what God said through the prophet. He said, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Praise the Lord. So how do I get hurt? How do you get hurt? When we lack understanding. All right? That's why it's important not only to receive the word, but to unveil the knowledge of truth. When you start understanding the knowledge of truth, it just illuminates your life. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I am one that believes in getting educated. I don't put down education. Okay? I believe spirituality and education together is a wonderful thing. Praise the Lord. Okay? So that means we got to study our Bible. You have to be a student of the Word. Praise God. Now, in Luke 16:8, go there, please. Luke 16:8. Now Jesus said, in Hosea 4:6, God said through the prophet Hosea that his people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. In Luke 16:8, praise the Lord, Jesus spoke, and Jesus said, very powerful statement he was teaching us. So the master commanded the unjust steward, because he had dealt shrewdly. For the sons of this world are more shrewd in their generation than the sons of light. Jesus says the children of this world in their generation wiser than the children of light. Now that's a shame that we are children of light and we don't pay attention. We don't have the understanding that the people in the world do. Praise God. So we also should get educated. Okay? Right. Be up to par to what's going on. Remember, we don't put our focus, we don't put our focus on current event. We put our focus on the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? All right. So good. So that means that the children of this world has learned a system, the world system, and they have learned how to operate in that system. Now, I know that some of you know this. Well, Jesus said that we are not from this world. Amen. Jesus said that he was not from this world. Excuse me. All right. He told them, you are from this world. I come from another world. Now, everyone here, the Lord is in your heart, right? So that means you are an ambassador in this world for the gospel. Praise God. So you may be in this world, but you're not from this world also, okay? So it's important for us to learn the system from the world we came from. And once we learn that system, how to operate it, then Deacon Rory, everything is going to be all right. Because the system that we've been utilizing is not a system that belongs to us. It's a system that belongs to the children of the world. Okay? So we are children of light, so we need to learn the system of light. Listen how I heard it in the spirit. Once I learn the system of light, I will have life. Praise the Lord, because light is life. Praise God. So this world system says, grab and hold it. Grab it and hold it. Don't let it go. Whatever you get, you better keep it. It says, work day and night. Focus on working. Oh, another thing it tells you, seek to be rich. You got to get rich. Give yourself totally to the work. So it keeps you away from your family. Keeps you away from the important things. That's why it's important for us to understand the system that we've been working is a system from this world and not a system that comes from light. All right? Now, let's learn a system that comes from God. Because it's totally opposite in the system we know here. So in Luke 6:38, and I'm sure most of you are aware of Luke 6:38. Luke chapter 6, let's go there please. Verse 38, excuse me, I'm sorry. That's 6:38. In 6:38, he says, give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your bosom. For the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. But the key here is, or the system that we need to learn, the principle is, give. and it shall be given to you. So whatever I give myself to is going to give me back something. Okay? In lame language, or lay language. If I give myself to an area of my life, let's say this, I give myself to exercising, then obviously I'm going to change my physical appearance. If I give myself to eating correctly, then obviously I'm going to give myself to being healthy. So whatever you give, praise the Lord, give, and it shall be given to you. Now, talking about your needs, I love what he said in Philippians 4:19. I want us to go there. Because a lot of times, we just lose it when we don't understand that God really is in the midst, and God's watching over us, and God's not going to leave us nor forsake us. Praise God. So in Philippians 4:19, he says, can we please go there? Philippians 4:19. Excuse me. Philippians 4:19. He says, and God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So my supplier is Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. So obviously, the more I give to my supplier, the more I shall receive. And I'm talking about your time. I'm talking about your talent. And then I'm talking about your treasure. Because you can't pay the mortgage or pay the rent, you know, without the currency that you need. So it's a participation from everybody. Everyone is supposed to participate and give their part so that this gospel can be heard and, of course, preach and teach to all the nation. Amen. So, in 2 Corinthians, let's go there, please. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, okay, please. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6. He says, but this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. And then he says in verse 7, so let each one give as he purposed in his heart, not grudgingly or out of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. See? And then in verse 8, he says, and God is able to make all grace abound towards you. I believe that goes with Philippians 4:19. He'll supply all our needs, Sister Michelle, according to his riches and glory. I'm not depending on what I can do. I'm depending on what he can do. And then you can cross-reference this with Psalm 23, verse 1, when you can stand in front of the face of trouble or problem and say, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Excuse me. So, Jesus said, God said, now it's up to us to do. Praise God. We are godly people, aren't we? Then we're supposed to prosper because God wants us to prosper. Okay? Prosper in the gospel. Prosper in your health. Prosper in your mind. Prosper financially. It's a whole pie, you know? God doesn't want you struggling. God doesn't want you in a position that you don't know if you're going to come or go or what you're going to. God wants you in a place that that the Lord is your shepherd, and you shall not want. I think that's a prosperous place to be. Praise the Lord. So, obviously, if I need a new direction in business, I should go to my supplier. If I want a new job, I should go to my supplier. If I want a raise in the job that I'm in, I should go to my supplier. And I should go into his word, because his word gives me wisdom for these areas that I want to prosper in. Praise the Lord. Okay? So write this down. First, I must know that it is God's will for me, take it personal, for me to prosper. And I believe a lot of times we don't realize that we're prosperous or blessed, or I believe that a lot of time we can't get further because there's a situation that we have. Our soul hasn't prospered. And if my soul don't prosper first, the exterior is not going to prosper. When my soul prosper, oh God, everything else will just flow and flourish. Praise the Lord. That's why he said in 3 John 2, let's go there please, family. 3 John 2, all right? In 3 John 2, he said, Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prosper. Okay. So, obviously, God's word gives us the wisdom for prosperity, right? And look how he's saying, I want you to prosper. Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things. I really wish you received this. In all things. And be in health. He's concerned about your health. Just as your soul prosper. But the key word here is soul. Is your soul prospering? Because if your soul can't prosper, then you're not going to prosper. And then, how am I going to be healthy if my soul ain't prospering? And I believe that one of the problems in the body of Christ is this. Their soul's not prospering. Praise the Lord. They're not thinking right. Incorrect thinking. And then we've been taught years ago that the soul of a man is the inner link that connects the spirit with the body. And then the soul and the spirit of man are not the same. They're not the same. Because the Bible divides the two. And if I lose my soul, I lose everything. What is it for a man to gain the world but to lose his? See? And here in 1 Thessalonians, go to 1 Thessalonians. I'm giving you scripture tonight. I know I am. I'm sorry. You're going to have to move. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. Says, now may the God of peace, again, now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. Sounds like 3 John 2 to me. Beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. Excuse me. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. And may your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who called you is faithful, who also will do it. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord that this epistle be read to all the holy brethren. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. A man is a spirit. Man is a spirit. And he has a soul. And he lives in a body. Praise the Lord. And I believe that the spirit of a man can receive revelation. Praise you, Father. Praise you. Now listen to what I'm saying. This is very deep. The spirit of a man can receive revelation before his intellect can become involved. That means God can give you revelation in the spirit before your mind get it. And your mind will be the last, because your mind don't know nothing about God. That's why it's important to be connected spiritually. Why would he say in John 6, chapter 6, verse 63, the words I speak to you are spirit and life. So my spirit can get revelation before my mind can. I wish I had someone that could say amen to this statement. Now, Apostle John is a good example. Remember Apostle John? He received many things by revelation. How did he receive that revelation? In his head? No, he received it in the spirit. So if you don't receive it in the spirit, ain't gonna really work. Go to 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. 1 John chapter 4. Oh God. 1 John, yes sir. 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. By revelation, John received this. You are of God. You are of God. Little children, and you have overcome them. Because he is in you is greater than he who's in the world. So we have overcome the system. So why are we still stuck in this system? Well, I'm in the world. Yeah, you're in the world, but you're not from the world. So how can I, how can I say this? Okay, yeah. How can I go to Spain, even though there's people that talk English over there, and I try to talk to a Spaniard in English? He's going to look at me and say, este americano está loco. He's going to say, this American is crazy. I don't understand him. So we've been trying to use a system that belongs to this world. It ain't going to work. Your system is different than this world system. In other words, like you've heard me say before, listen, folks, each and every one of us here, we were called to stand out. We wasn't called to fit in. So every time we try to fit in, we're just going to look idiot, like idiots. People are not going to pay attention to you. Write this down. My soul must prosper. God, I love you. Write it down. My soul must prosper. And you pray that. You start praying that. You hear me? God, I thank you, Father, for allowing my soul to prosper. You hear me? If you hear me, give me a good amen.
Amen.
Right. Start receiving revelation in the Spirit. Praise the Lord. It's time to start receiving revelation, instructions in the Spirit. Praise the Lord. Because a prosperous soul will produce prosperity. Praise the Lord. A prosperous soul will produce a prosperous image inside of you, inside of me. There's an image inside of us, and we need to develop it. Praise the Lord. Watch this here. I got a good story to take you to. My stories are different. My stories come from the Bible. So let's go to John chapter 5. Come on, everybody. Praise the Lord. Come on, somebody. Praise God. Thank Him. Worship Him and thank Him. Amen. He's worthy to be praised. In John chapter 5, let me see something. And I believe it starts in verse 6. Yes, we can go there. Yeah, verse 6. Let's go to verse 6. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" How many of us, Jesus doesn't say to us, "Do you want to be made well?" And watch what the man answered. But the sick man answered him, saying, "Sir, I have no man to put me in the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I'm coming another step down before me," Jesus said to him, rise, take up your bed and walk. See, Jesus didn't pay no attention to him. The guy wants to share his problem with Jesus. Nobody's letting me go in the pool. They said that an angel will come and stir up the pool. An angel will come from heaven. An angel will come from heaven and stir up the pool like a jacuzzi. And everyone that get in the pool will get healed. And you know who was talking to him? The Son of God, Jesus. And you know what Jesus said to him in the Spirit? "I'm higher than that angel. Do you want to get healed?" The answer either is yes or no. So tonight, Brother Rory, God's saying to us, do you want your soul to prosper? Either yes or no. If you don't want it to prosper, then stay in your position. But if you do want to prosper, then let's get in the pool. Because it's nice, it's like a nice jacuzzi right now. It's stirring up. Praise the Lord. It's ready to go. Okay? Jesus trying to talk to him and get him healed. And what's the man saying? The man's trying to get him. The man is going right back to zero. You don't understand. I've been here a long time. Jesus says, "I don't care about how long you've been here. I'm trying to get you to speak some faith. Let it come out of your mouth." But what happened? The man went back to zero. What do you mean zero? He zeroed in into his problem. Oh, praise the Lord, somebody. Some people's problem is bigger than Jesus or bigger than the Word. Praise God. See? They'd rather have the problem instead of having the solution. You have to have a desire. The only way your soul is going to prosper, you must have a desire for your mind to prosper. Look, go to Proverbs 13. Go to Proverbs 13. Watch this. You have to. Proverbs 13. Verse 12. Proverbs 13, verse 12. You must want it. You must want to go higher. Okay? The Spirit can take you higher. The Spirit can take you to a higher level. The Spirit can take you to that place of awareness, praise the Lord, a higher understanding, amen. Higher understanding. The Bible says in Proverbs 13:12, hope defers, makes the heart sick. But when the desire comes, it's a tree of life. The key word is desire. Desire comes, it's a tree of life. When desire comes, it's a tree of life. When desire comes, it's a tree of life. Without desire, I can't eat from the tree of life. Without desire, I have to desire. You know, same old. Well, you're the one tolerating that. You're the one saying yes to the same old, same old. Take this to another level. Praise the Lord. Take it to the other level because God already did it for you. Now it's up to you. Praise God. Desire. Desire for your soul to prosper. Go to Deuteronomy 28, please. Deuteronomy 28. No, I'm sorry. Proverbs 28. Go to Proverbs 28. I'm so sorry. Proverbs 28. We can go to Deuteronomy too if you like. We'll do that after if you like. But let's go to Proverbs 28. And once you're there, go to verse 13. There it is. Verse 13. Bless his holy name. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be magnified. He's worthy to be exalted. Thank you, Lord. You're so wonderful. Thank you, Father. Bless you, bless you, bless you. Amen. Well, in Proverbs 28, verse 13 says, he who covers his sins, his mistakes, will not prosper. But whoever confess and forsake them and stop doing them will have mercy. All right? So this is, if you want to prosper, you can't continue covering up your errors and thinking that you're okay. Oh, I'm all right the way I am. No, you're not. God wants more from you. That's why you're still alive. You haven't fulfilled your purpose. You can give me an amen if you like to. Praise the Lord. There's more for you to do. I'm sorry for your loss. I'm sorry for the things you don't have that you used to have. But you can have more if you like. And there's somebody out there waiting for you to come talk to them. And be a brother. Or a father. Or a friend. And it's time. It's time to do the will of God. And the will of God is for us to preach and teach this gospel to the nations. That's being prosperous there. Man, if you can do that, that's prosperous. That's prosperity. Okay, well, remember I said Deuteronomy 28, I said? Well, let's go to Deuteronomy 29. All right? But we're going to Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 29, that's the fifth book of the Bible. Let me see this here. Wait a minute. Yeah. Deuteronomy 29. And go to verse 9. Deuteronomy 29, verse 9. So the Bible says, therefore, keep the word of this covenant and do them that you may prosper in all that you do. There it is. This is how you go to a higher level. This is how you let your soul to prosper. Praise the Lord. This is how you build your image. This is how you build your image. Your image is not what you see in the mirror. It's what's inside of you. Remember 1 Samuel 16, verse 7? I believe it is. When Samuel the prophet went to Jesse's house and he was instructed to anoint the next king, and all Jesse's kids that were there, they were all strong looking and military looking, and he says, pfft. God said to Samuel, pfft, like that. None of them. There's none of them. And then Samuel said to Jesse, you ain't got no more kid? Yeah, I got one more young kid. He's in the farm, in the stable, in the barn. He pastures the animal, the sheep. Bring that one here. Let's see. And God said, that's the one. Because he knew David's heart. Praise the Lord. Come on now. He knew David's heart. God knows your heart. So, he's giving us an instruction tonight. He said, keep my word. Keep my covenant. Live for me. And what's going to happen? Everything you do will prosper. So, hey, listen to me. When you go do a job, you know what you need to do before you do the job? This one, I'm going to do it in the name of the Lord. Try it, man. Write it down. God's giving you instruction right now. This one, I'm going to do it in the name of the Lord. And see what happens. When you go paint the house, this one, I do it in the name of the Lord. When you go clean the house, this one, I do it in the name. And whatever you do, this one, I'm going to do in the name of the Lord. You know, people in the body of Christ, rather, they like being more religious. But when you start giving them revelation in the spirit, they're like, what's that? Don't be like that, folks. Receive what the Lord is telling you. This one, I'm doing it in the name of the Lord. You're keeping his covenant. And he says that whatever you do, you're going to prosper. I'm going to prosper in this one. Because I'm doing it in the name of the Lord. I'm doing it unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm here unto the Lord. Praise God. I'm doing this one in the name of the Lord. And then, of course, if you really want good instruction and how to prosper your soul, do you? Okay, I can give you one or two more, can I? Okay, let's go to Psalm. Let's go to Psalm chapter 1. What a great psalm. In the book of Psalm, excuse me, Psalm chapter 1, Psalm chapter 1, and we can read Psalm 1:1. I love the way he starts. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Pardon me. He says, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly. In other words, blessed is the man who's not following the children of this world. I'm not getting any help here. Nor stands in the path of the sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. Verse 2, but his delight is in the law, the word of the Lord. And in his law, in the word, he meditates day and night. Well, this person, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Listen, look at me. That brings fruit, praise God, from the inside out. That brings forth its fruit. in its season. There's a season for everything and a reason. Whose leaf also shall not wither. See, once you're in the covenant, you're not going to wither away. And whatever he does shall prosper. That's a person who's meditating day and night. That's a person who has a soul that is prospering. Because he's receiving revelation in the spirit. And then he can shoot it up to his mind, to his soul. And then his intellect can process it. The ungodly are not so. The ungodly are not so. But are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. That's us. We're an instrument of righteousness. Say that. That's me. I'm an instrument of righteousness. I'm an instrument of righteousness. Praise the Lord. Say it. Say it loud and say it proud. You're an instrument of righteousness. Praise God. Because remember what John said to us through the revelation that God gave him through the, in the Spirit in 1 John 4:4. We just read it. He said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. In other words, he said, I ain't following those jokers. They're the children of the world. I'm a children of light. And then he says, nor the sinner in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous. Verse 6, please. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous. For the Lord knows if you desire for your soul to prosper. But the way of the ungodly shall perish. One more scripture. Joshua 1:8. In the book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 8, what a wonderful instruction. He starts out saying, this book of the law, this book of the word, shall not depart from your mouth. See? So when you stand before that new, when you finish that job, you should bless it. Listen, this is how you get increase. See, we're so, we're just carnal, man. We're just carnal. We're so accustomed to the carnality, it's unreal. It's time for us that you start using God's word, the spirit in life. It's time for us to start receiving revelation in the spirit. Praise the Lord. Let's try it again. This book of the law, this book of the word should not depart from my mouth, but I shall meditate in it day and night, that I may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then I will make my way prosperous, and then I will have good success. You take this scripture, and you take it personal, and you read it like that. I need you praying every day. I need you worshiping God every day. I need you to take time out for the Lord and recognize him every day. That's how you're going to build relationship. You don't go to him just when you need him. Oh, God, I'm in trouble. You don't do that. You go to him every day. And you tell him, Lord, my God, I worship you. Yes, I really do, Lord. Yes, I do. Lord, my God, and I worship you. When you get in your vehicle, thank him for your vehicle. When you get inside your house, thank him for your house. When you get in your bed, thank him for your bed. That's how you build a relationship. When you see a significant other, thank them. When you see your family member, thank them. And if your family member is like my family member, I miss my dad, my father, my carnal father. But I still laugh and I say, Father, thank you that he's in heaven. See? I know that I'm going to see him again. Praise the Lord. Desire for your soul to prosper. I want to talk to the viewers out there. Praise God. It is time for you to start prospering the image that is inside of you. And how do you do that? Number one, you must have desire. According to Proverbs 13:12, you must have desire. Let it come in. All right? Number two, you have to meditate in the Word. The word that I hear is you have to become mindful for the Word. Praise the Lord. So start practicing mindfulness in the Word of God. I'm talking to you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Start doing that. Let it come in. You can't release what you don't have. You cannot release what you don't have. Let it come in Jesus' name. And remember, Jesus is Lord. Thank you. I'm honored. I'll see you real soon. God bless you. Amen. Praise the Lord.